The argument we are going to deal with is referred to accommodation, agritourism in Sicily. Definition: agritourism is a form of rural tourism in which the tourist is hosted on a farm. It can be considered as an exclusively Italian specificity in the European tourist sector, thanks to particular rules which regulate it in our country. In fact, in Italy, the term agriturismo was firstly recognized with a special law, the General Policy Law number 730, on December 5, 1985. Agritourism is a commercial enterprise in a working farm, ranch, or agriculture plant managed for the enjoyment of visitors that generate supplemental income for the owner. Farms and ranches recreation refers to activities conducted on private agricultural lands, which might include fishing, overnight stays, educational activities, etc. Agritourism and nature tourism enterprises might include outdoor recreation, educational experiences, entertainment, hospitality services, on-farm direct sales. Agritourism is a subject of a large industry called rural tourism that includes the resorts of such farmers, markets, non-profit agricultural tours, and other leisure and hospitality businesses that attract visitors to the countryside. Rural tourism differs from agritourism in two ways. Rural tourism enterprises don't necessarily occur on a farm or ranch or at an agricultural plant. They don't generate a supplemental income for the agricultural enterprise. Agritourism is a combination of the words for agriculture and the tourism in Italian, in a style of vacation in farming house and resorts. It has become popular in countries with scenic rural areas such as Italy, Ireland, and India. Recently, this form of tourism has become increasingly popular. In Italy, most agritourism vacations are suitable for the whole family, but there are some varieties. The Italian agritourism. Starting in the 1950s and continuing through the 1970s, small-scale farming in Italy became less profitable and farmers abandoned many farms to search for work in larger towns. However, Italians confer great value and worth in their agricultural traditions, especially in the small-scale production of foods like cheese, wine, and olives. By 1980s, Italian lawmakers had created a legal definition of agritourism, which allowed for the rehabilitation and the restoration of many abandoned rural buildings and estates. Some were turned into vacation homes and others were converted into agritourism accommodations, similar to English or American bed and breakfasts. This agriturismi, that is the plural form for agriturismo, allowed small farmers to augment, to improve an income from the farm, vacationer to have the unique first-hand experience of the rural way of life in Italy.
Food in an agriturismo, in Italian agriturismo will usually serve request food that was prepared from raw materials produced on the farm of or from other local merchants. Some will allow the guests to participate in the activities surrounding the farm, such as picking the vegetables or milking the goats. Despite the rural nature of the lodging, one might expect a rustic experience. But a great many agritourism are again and future
amenities
like swimming pools. You will be in the Italian countryside, but you won't be roaming in by any means.
different varieties of agritourism. Agritourism is so popular that there are even subcategories of agritourism convention. For those seeking an environmentally friendly holiday, many farms offer ecotourism alternatives with total immersion in nature. Tourists seeking a little pampering may opt for a wellness agritourism experience at a farm that offers spa services and treatments. Agritourism is a new type of rural tourism, which is generally implemented in disadvantaged agricultural lands. It is developed as a sector with the aim of not only a development in industrial for local people who are dependent on agricultural production, but also for sustaining the agricultural lands. Therefore, agritourism can be defined as a range of activities, services, and amenities provided by farmers and rural people to attract tourists to their area in order to generate extra income for their business.
Landscape is the result of the ways that different components of our surrounding environment, physical, biological, and social, interact and become perceived. Therefore, landscape is concerned with and manifests in the various forms of the complex interrelationship between people and place. In agritourism, landscape incorporates human-made and peaceful elements such as number one, agritourism facilities and attractions, number two, infrastructures specifically developed for tourism, accommodation, food supplements, etc. Number three, environmental elements, air, water, soil. Number four, basic infrastructures such as transportation, network, water supply, sewage, solid waste disposal systems, etc. And finally, number five, the landscapes as a wall and so on. Landscape architect's role is to plan and design landscapes and open spaces for projects such as parks, schools, institutions, roads, external areas for commercial, industrial and residential cities, and plan and monitor their construction, maintenance, management, and rehabilitation. This role is very important since it concerned with the shaping of landscapes at water scales.
Aims are to create, enhance, maintain and protect places so as to be functional, aesthetically pleasing, meaningful and sustainable, and appropriate to diverse human needs and goals. Landscape architects must have a holistic knowledge and understanding of landscape in time and space, and the pressures and driving forces to which landscapes are subjected. They involve not only specialist knowledge from a wide range of disciplines, but also the interests of the public. The role of a landscape architect in the design of an agritourism landscape is to combine the production, representative and recreational areas. The designed area needs to be recognized, researched and analyzed with the methods used in the landscape architecture.
The analysis of an agritourism tourism landscape design project consists of an inventory of the agricultural area with existing plants, surfaces, small architectural elements, a soil pH analysis, a landscape evaluation of valorization of chosen elements, a landscape analysis, a functional separation of the area with specification of the zones designated for the determined recreational activities and adjusted to the age of the participants. An interview with the owner of the facility and the guests survey, allowing to obtain their opinion about the green space, their expectations and preferences. The second task is to develop designing guidelines and to create the concept meaning the arrangement of an area under the form of the top view, with the consideration of the greenery composition communication system and the elements of smaller architecture, often with the preliminary measurements. That will be supplemented with the catalogues of plans, surfaces proposed, equipment and elements, finishing materials, also review of inspirations. The contribution of the landscape architect is crucial for the design, promotion and protection of an agritourism landscape. However, the design should meet those quality standards that will guide agritourism in safety, predictable targets not to begin to assimilate the mass tourism.
Agritourism in Sicily. Agritourism in Sicily gives the opportunity to plunge into a familiar and friendly atmosphere, to taste the local products belonging to the Sicilian cuisine. Top now, the most characteristic feature of its interland, in contact with nature. Most of Sicilian agritourism are real resorts, offering a quiet and serenity, but a practical strategic point from which tourists can reach art cities. In Sicilian agritourism, the thematic roses have been created to integrate the products and their origin territories, in order to make understand their belonging to that land, culture and tradition characterizing and giving it a value of uniqueness. Thanks to the presence of numerous categories of wines which have received the designation of origin, the wine tourism, the ways of wine,
le strade del vino,
has been
laid in such a way,
affirmed and it has determined the birth of new paths, the ways of taste and flowers.
And flavors. The ways of wine in Sicily are Vino Bianco d'Alcamo DOC, Strada del Vino dell'Etna, Strada del Vino Insonia or Ansonica, Strada del Vino Malvasia delle Liberi, delle Isole Eolie, Strada del Vino Marsale del Moscato di Pantelleria e ancora di Siracusa, del Nero d'Avola, del Cerasuolo di Vittoria, Strada del Vino Terre Sicane e poi ancora la Strada del Vino Val di Mazzara. The eating habits of Magna Graecia, the delicacies of Monsur coming from the great noble cuisines, the Arabic sweets and the Jewish offal contributed to make varied the Sicilian cuisine. Among the Sicilian ways of taste and flavors, there are the ways of cheese of Mount Sicani, la way or the way of red oranges of Monte Etna, the ways of oil. In Sicily, there are six ways of oils: Monsi Blei, Valleys of Trapani, Valley of Mazzara, Mount Etna, Valdemone, and Valley of Belce.
Agritourism in Sicily allow to valorize interland areas which are often abandoned and unexplored. Besides, Sicilian enogastronomy is varied and articulated, very appreciated both by Italian and foreign tourists. The furnishing details determine the success of an agritourism, which offers to its hosts the typical atmosphere of a real rural house and the ancient farm life. These elements will be necessary to create a bond with the past and a proper relaxing atmosphere. Each single agriturismo should be planned in order to be harmonious with the surrounding environment, old farms or ancient house. Styles to be adopted have to respect the sense of ancient conveyed by the same edifice. In this way, from a stylistic point of view, two choices will occur, the classical and the country rustic.
The choice of materials for furnishing is important. The preference is devoted to handcrafted woods, antiquated in poor art or country styles, contributing to enhance a certain rustic atmosphere, intimate but friendly and at the same time. Such a building by the exploitation of exposed wood beams or whitewashed, so that wood can be stood out in specific places of furniture, chairs, nightstand, and chairs. In the living and dining rooms, it will be of great effect to locate cupboard and plate racks with walls and tiles ornament with different cover objects and flower or dried trees. Bedrooms are characterized by beds with woody exposures and in added nightstands. Terracotta parquet, irregular single color stones and tiles floor adapted well to the environment. Furniture in poor art are characterized by very simple linens and thanks to the solid wood by which they are shielded. They take typical precious shades, natural and antique tones. In conclusion, wood is one material for the building adapted as a farmhouse.
Agritourism represents a pleasant reality in our territory. They attract tourists coming from abroad, but also local weekenders. Guest room can be accessed through an indoor stairway. The trussed roof is wooden, with earthquake-proof iron beams in compliance with the latest provisions. Guest bedroom may be made particular thanks to the usage of stones to decorate walls or pillars. Their decorative function has been discovered recently and exalted in order to create a typical rustic environment, comfortable and cozy, even exploiting pre-existing old materials treated according to the design planned and desired by the same owners.
Rooms can be also be defined by a simple size, avoiding a strict relationship with rustic design. The materials exploited are simple neutral paintings, parquets in brioche, oak, or stonework, tiles, wall Well, are usually employed by modern style in house planning. If the classic taste provides the best long my decorated with the period for this room. Sofas and armchair for the rearing. Cartels for a round of cars. Beautiful paintings of the Sicilian landscapes and portraits usually decorate the walls. The styles indicated above for bedrooms also refer to the wall system design planned for each typical agriturism. The common feature among all the local agriturism is receiving in the warmest way possible daily requests. Creating a series of activities related to the lifestyle of the farmer. Establishing a friendly but at the same intimate atmosphere tracks the exploitation of materials used to decorate the building and its rooms, which are made precious by ancient and typical furniture, adapting the rustic environment to the needs of guests. Sometimes more turned to the modern style. According to all these features, we can affirm that agriturism represents a pleasant reality in our territory and attract tourists coming from abroad but also local weekenders.
Now our key lesson has just finished and we would like to thank you for your attention. Bye.
Bye.
Bye.